Hey everybody, boys, Sasha VK Forest. Welcome to the Commodity Dollars for April 15th to April 19th, 2019, for Aussie dollar, dollar CAD, and Kiwi dollar. Story in the Com Dollar land has been a mild kind of a recovery for the Aussie and the Kiwi. Caddy just essentially remains almost in the exact same state it was the week prior in this very low volatility compression. Overall, as usual, volatility in the Com Dollar land has actually been very, very small, although we are perhaps starting to finally peel away from the 20 SMA on the Aussie. Let's take a look at the levels first, and then we'll take a look at what the event risk in front of us is. So Aussie now kind of moved off that 70 level to now 71, 72 to the top side. 72, very, very critical level here. If we can break through 72, even 72.50, that puts Aussie in a much more upward path than it has been over the last 6 to 8 weeks. Dollar CAD, it's essentially anybody's bet. It's a 34 to the upside, 33 to the downside, still very much that trade. And the triangle compression that you see on the charts just remains in place. Not much event risk in front of us. Aussie has huge event risk that could, in many ways, determine whether this rally is real or not as we go forward. Kiwi has some event risk, and Kiwi has been dragging behind Aussie for the last couple of weeks, but we saw finally a little bit of a rebalancing in the Aussie Kiwi. We'll talk a little bit about that in the crosses section. But Kiwi right now certainly holding a 67 relatively consistently, but 68 remains to be very much a resistance point for the trade. On the calendar, really not that much in Com Dollar land. We do have the services index. We'll see. We're bearish that number because we had a weaker PMI number in front of us. Depending how bearish, it's gonna really determine where the Aussie is. It's the first thing that comes out to us Sunday, to you guys Monday. RBA minutes, interesting to see. I mean, the bell was not as bearish this week. That's one of the things that really flipped the Aussie to the upside. It was not as bearish as the market expected. In other words, the RBA is still very much in the wait and see mode rather than in a aggressively considering rate cut mode. All of this is very much contingent on employment data. And that's really where the whole rubber meets the road this week, because it's the Australian employment data right over here on Wednesday that in so many ways is going to, I think, be the pivotal decision point. If that prints negative or really sort of, you know, shocks the market to the downside, we unemployment rate goes up to 5.1, change becomes negative, participation rate gets worse. If all those factors get worse, the pricing in a rate cut is going to skyrocket, and Aussie is going to flip right around, could take the 20 SMA to the downside, and perhaps then establish a truly downward trend. If that is benign, I think that's going to just reaffirm the Bell's point of view that the RBA is not going anywhere. And it could give us, or at least embolden the bulls to push us through the 72, 72.50 level. So that, I think, is going to be the pivotal event as we go forward. On the Kiwi side, we have the CPI data. That should be actually interesting. We'll see if that's mildly bullish. NZD, it doesn't really matter. The RBNZ is certainly not going to be in any way hiking. But one of the interesting things is that I think if the data out of Australia is weak, it's probably going to spill over into New Zealand as well. And I'll tell you why, because the RBNZ was so dovish on the last statement that if they see that, you know, the economy across the Tasmanian Sea is deteriorating, they may, in concert with the RBA, cut rates at the next quarterly market meeting. So I think both could get impacted negatively on a weak jobs print as we go forward. Finally, the last thing that we have on the Com Dollar land as far as funded data goes, Canadian CPI, not much. We're mildly bullish that data set, but there really isn't anything there. Retail sales on Thursday should be, no, yeah, retail sales on Thursday, not Friday, Thursday, should also be an interesting look here. We're mildly bullish that. CAD still kind of a very, very tight range. The market just is not seeing any new story going on over there. And keeping it very tight. Let's take a look at the charts, and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So first, let's take a look at the Aussie. Aussie, if you look at the Aussie over the last month and a half, it's been a chop seller's delight. I mean, you sell the highs, buy the lows 1,000 times over. This is like a range trading a nirvana for anybody who just simply trades for 50 points to the upside to the downside. You literally could not lose money. It's a trend trader's nightmare. I don't think we've gotten more killed in any currency pair over the last a month and a half than the Aussie in terms of fake outs, both to the downside and to the upside. What's interesting about this week, and it's interesting about the charts as you look at them now, is that we're seeing a tiny bit of inkling of an upside pull away. You see how we're starting to really pull away from the 20 SMA. The bias certainly is turning to the upside. We do have this massive overhead around the 72 area. But if the positive labor data comes in, I think that bursts us right straight through that 72 and really puts 73 into play. It really creates a much stronger bottoming out process and a much stronger trend to the upside that then goes out there and chases the long-term SMA than anything that we've seen in a long time. But we need, I think, the positive narrative to get that to happen. If we get a shockingly bad number, it could, the chop traders delight. They could just take us right back down. More importantly, it could take us through the SMA. And if the data is really horrid, we could have two sustained days where the Aussie could then come back and test the 70. So you have to be prepared for both scenarios here. Although for the near term, certainly the technicals right now pointing to the upside, and until we get to Wednesday, the flows are benign towards the bulls. The Kiwi, similar kind of a story in a more muted fashion. Kiwi is underneath the SMA, still has a long way to go. It held the 67. It's barely holding on. We do have, as I said, just mild Kiwi data. It didn't show it on the calendar. We do have the milk dairy auction on Wednesday. That could also be positive if that comes in and provides further boost to the Kiwi. But overall, basically, the cap here seems to be the 68. That's a very, very hard cap to break. For this to get truly bullish and the market get much more constructive on Kiwi, we need to come back and capture and close above the 20 SMA, which is around the 68. That would give us a much stronger upside signal. And then finally, CADI, really the same story as it was last week, up, down, but the triangle compression still stays in place. It's still a 34-33 bet upside to the downside, looking like it could break to the downside. I mean, this is all essentially, there's just this mild positive comm dollar drift all across the complex. And if you simply look at the price action, it feels like the market is positioning itself for further rally across all the comm dollar land. And that's pretty much how you want to come out front of the week. But beware that these signals are still relatively weak, and keep your stops relatively tight because for now, it's still chop traders' delight. Wish you guys the best luck, the best trading. Boris Schlossberg, over and out.